Gude. So I was browsing the internet and I came across a cool tutorial to burn wood, but chemically. I saw it on the Laura Kampf channel, link below. The old way to burn wood is like take a soldering iron and heat it up and use the tip as a stylus and paint whatever you like. This way you get a really sharp image and a nice image, but it takes time. You need a special soldering tip and so on. And there's actually another way, by using ammonium chloride in a water solution. Just paint it somewhere and then use a heat gun to actually burn it, because it will carburate the wood at a lower temperature than the hot air alone will do. So the idea was, okay, I don't have to buy anything. I just take my my fan. This is like a hairdryer, and this should give me enough heat to use this, right? So basically what happened was that it just evaporated the water and no carburation. See, nothing happens. So I thought maybe it is not hot enough. Okay, and let's check out how hot this gets. Okay, so 160 was the maximum when we almost blocked the whole airflow and nothing happened. Here you see what you do to your hair if you put the hairdryer too close to it. And this isn't a really powerful one. I think it sucks like 200 watts or something. But there are way more beefier hairdryers than this one. Okay, so what I had to do was get another tool, obviously, because I didn't have it so far. Looks promising, does it? Get them at me. I think they just bought the Chinese stuff and rebranded it. So it should get like 500. Oh, it's getting white. Nice. But that's not the color we wanted. So let's use the temperature gauge again and let's try it on one. So, what did we learn? We need about 200 degrees, and it actually works. Nice! Laura got her stuff from a pharmacy, not apothecary. I got mine from the hardware store, or from an electronic store, because this is Salmiak stuff, and this is actually, they told me this is used to clean your soldering tip, but I have no idea how this works. I tried it and it didn't work, but now I have actually use for it. Okay, let's see what we can do with it. Okay, I think you get the idea. So, what did we learn? It works. Ammonium chloride and wood leads to burnt wood or charcoal if you apply more than 200 degrees Celsius of heat with your heat gun. And we also learned your average hairdryer, because I have the average hairdryer obviously, will just output about 120 degrees Celsius of hot air. So it's lacking about 100 degrees. Well, if you want to try this, you actually need a heat gun. And if you stick with around 200 degrees, you don't burn the wood. You just encouraged the ammonium chloride to react with the wood. I didn't check it out, right? Did I? Okay, let's have a closer look at this thing before we end. I think you remember this box. This is the build according to the template from AVE, so it's perfect. No, it's not perfect, it's skookum. Skookum as freak. What you didn't saw was that I measured the average hairdryer and it turned around 200 watts of energy in about 120 degrees of heat. And now I want to compare it to the heat gun that is actually made for blasting heat. 1000 watt for 350 and 2000 watt for 550 degrees. So now I burn the cables. It's getting better and better. I think we're getting there. 1000 watts. Let's check the watts. Nothing happens. Okay, we turn it on. And it doesn't take 1000 watts, it takes just 900 watts, which is 10% less. And let's check the high setting. Okay, it's 170 instead of 2000, so it's 15% less. Let's see if we can actually reach the 350 degrees in the low setting. We were like at 320 something. Okay, the plastic is melting. It starts to melt the heat shrink. Actually, it didn't melt it, it just burned it right off. And I don't know what's the highest temperature this thing can output. But we got around 300 degrees and it's smoking again a little bit. That's perfect. This doesn't fit at all. Because it's too loose, and this doesn't fit because it's too tight. Okay, it works. Oh, that's okay, but that is garbage. It's just getting better from here. Nice, nice, nice. And the tolerance is perfect. Nah, you get what you pay for. Oh, it's smoking. Normally it's a good sign if your gun smokes after you use it, but if it's a heat gun, I don't think it should smoke. Okay, this thing is worth every penny of the 15 bucks I paid for it. Yep, that's it. Thanks a lot for watching.